the historic city of Lausanne on the shores of Lake Geneva, one of the world's most picturesque locations. A cultural and vibrant centre with a rich heritage, situated at the heart of Europe. Its lakeside setting providing a relaxed atmosphere where the pace of life slows right down. It could mean enjoying a leisurely Sunday afternoon stroll, or perhaps being a little bit more adventurous. With such a mix of attractions, it's hardly surprising that Lausanne is a favourite tourist destination. The old town serves as a reminder of medieval times. At its heart, the 13th century cathedral, which overlooks the city, recognised as one of the most beautiful Gothic art monuments in Europe. Everywhere you look, there's something to attract your attention, from the distinctive floral display which adorns the town hall, to the nearby square where figurines let you know the time. A blend of ancient and modern, and, inevitably, all eyes eventually drawn to the magnificent Lake Geneva with its wonderful panoramic views. The perfect backdrop for the majestic Beau Rivage Palace, one of Europe's finest hotels. A famous landmark which has never closed its doors since 1861, and over the years has played host to many illustrious guests, such as Victor Hugo, Charlie Chaplin, Coco Chanel, and Nelson Mandela. Top of its guest list were the leaders and other key decision makers from the world of sport. Some 109 international sports federations and associate members gathered for the annual SportAccord IF Forum. Innovation and technology, the theme of the forum, presided over by Marius Wieser, president of SportAccord and SportAccord Convention. He was joined by Thomas Back, president of the International Olympic Committee, which has its headquarters in Lausanne. Delegates shared ideas on how innovation and technology can keep them ahead of the field.
Our target and our strategy for the sport in the future is to attract those areas of public which are not connected to the sport in generally, and showing them highlights and short news. I think it is a great opportunity to bring them in the first contact with the sport, and after also through to the media, our new media platform and social media platform, to feed them slowly and to attract them for to have a huge community and to transfer much better the sport values to the society and to the whole community.
A keynote address at the IF Forum came from Nadia Comaneci, who became the first gymnast in Olympic history to be awarded the perfect score of 10. She was 14 when she produced a flawless performance on the uneven bars at the 1976 Games in Montreal. And back then, technology couldn't cope.
The scoreboard was not ready to accommodate a perfect 10 because nobody thought this is possible. And when the scoreboard was created just before the Olympics, it didn't have enough light bulbs before the decimal. And when the judges awarded the highest score, the only way they could do it was to show 1.00.
Comaneci quite literally took innovation into her own hands at the end of her routine at the SportAccord IF Forum by performing a handstand in high heels. Use of television, social media and data in this fast-moving world of technology was very much at the heart of discussions at the IF Forum as delegates examined the best way to share expertise and ideas. A fascinating insight into biometric monitoring explained how sensors on athletes provide vital information designed to improve performance and well-being. The sport of basketball has certainly enjoyed tremendous growth, realizing the value and potential of innovation and technology.
We obviously have been innovating relatively fast already several years ago on applications where you can follow the results of your favorite team, wherever it's playing, whether it's in Africa, in Asia, or things like this. So that's already there since some time. But because technology changes so fast, you have to be all the time, you know, you always have to be there. So coming here is an opportunity then to listen to what's next.
The IF Forum learned about the new look SportAccord convention in Sochi in Russia in April 2015. Appropriately, legacy will be one of the themes after the Olympic Winter Games and Paralympics were held in the Black Sea Resort in 2014. It'll be the first World Sport and Business Summit with a much enlarged format. SportAccord signed an agreement with the Taishan Sports Industry Group of China, a partnership which results in the company becoming official supplier of SportAccord for 4 years. The organisation is also collaborating with Euronews, which begins broadcasting a new weekly sports magazine show in 2015, capturing the raw emotion in sport, while a significant agreement has also been signed with the International Fair Play Committee. So the IF Forum proves a winner for international sports federations, once again at the heart of the action.